हेलो फ्रेंड्स, जय स्वामीनारायण।
आई एम राजेंद्र पटेल,
स्टैंडर्ड 6 इंग्लिश मीडियम, सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स। फ्रेंड्स, लास्ट पीरियड वी स्टडीड अबाउट रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन, सम नंबर 10 अप टू 11। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट सम नंबर 12, 13 एंड 14। फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज द चैप्टर रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन, सम नंबर 12। कॉस्ट ऑफ अ डजन पेन्स इज रुपीज 180 एंड कॉस्ट ऑफ 8 वोल्ट पेन इज रुपीज 56। फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ द कॉस्ट ऑफ अ पेन टू द कॉस्ट ऑफ अ वोल्ट पेन। अ पेन एंड अ वोल्ट पेन, इट मीन्स ओनली वन पेन एंड वन वोल्ट पेन, बट वी हैव गिवन द प्राइस इन द जन एंड 8 वोल्ट पेन। तो फर्स्ट व्हाट वी डू, फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड the price of one pen and one ball pen. Therefore, price of a pen is equal to 180 divided by 12. How? Because one dozen is equal to 10 pieces. Now, divide 180 divided by 12. So, 180 divided by 12. 12 one ja 12. 8 minus 2, 6, 0 down, 12, 5, yeah, 60. Answer is 15. The price of a pen, means one pen is rupees 50. 50, no. Now, price of a one ball pen, means a ball pen is equal to total rupees 56 and 8. 8, 7, yeah. 56 rupees 7. Now we have a price of one pen and one ball pen. So now ratio of a price of a pen and a ball pen is equal to 15 upon 7. The answer is 50 is to 7. So this is the ratio of a one pen and one ball pen. So friends, first we have to find the price of a pen and a ball pen, then we can find the ratio. Now divide 20 pens between Sita and Sangeeta in the ratio of 3 is to 2. The friends, first the total part is equal to 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. 3 is to 2 means 3 plus 2 5. And Sila and Sangeeta, so Sila has 3 part out of 5. So Sila has 3 part out of 5, means 3 upon 5, like this. Sangeeta has 2 part out of 5, means 2 upon 5. Like this. Now, how many total pens? 20 pens. So, 3 upon 5 part of 20 is equal to 3 upon 5 into 20. 5 for the 20. 3 for the 12. So, Sila has 12 pens. Okay. Now, 2 upon 5 part of 20 is 2 upon 5 into 20. 5 4 jaa 20. 2 4 jaa 8 pence. Who has? Sangeeta has.
Then
Sangeeta has 8 pence and Sheela has 12 pence. So when we have given the ratio and we want to find things, then we have to do total part and third part which we given, 3/5 and 2/5, then divide. Now friends, our sum number 14. Consider the statement, ratio of the breadth and length of a hall is 2:5. 2:5. Complete the following table that shows sum possible breadth and length of the hall. We have given here breadth of the hall in meters, 10 meters, and length 25 meters. If we divide 10/25, so 5 to the 10, 5, 5 is 25, 2/5. So we have given 2:5. So now we have given in second table, in second box, length of the hall in meters 50. So suppose we choose x as a breadth of hall. Now we have to find how we can find that. Suppose the breadth of hall is x meter. Now x/50, this is breadth, is equal to, we have given ratio 2/5. So friends, how we got 50 here? So 50 divided by 5. 5 1 ja 5, 0, 0 down 0. So 10 5 ja 50. So here 10 5 ja 50. So friends, how we got 50? So if I multiply 5 by 10, then 2 also 10, 2 by 10, so 20. 20/50. So friends, the length of breadth of hall is equal to 20 meters. Like this, we find the value of x is equal to 20. X is equal to 20. Like this. Now we have given breadth and we want to find length. Suppose this is what? So length of the hall is y meter. Friends, we have given 40 breadth and y. How we can? Is equal to 2/5. Why write 2:5? Because ratio we have given 2:5. So how I got 40? So 2 20s are 40. 2 20s are 40. Like 40 लाने के लिए 2 को 20 से मल्टीप्लाई किया तो 5 को भी 20 से मल्टीप्लाई, तो 22 जा 40 एंड 12 5 जा 100. तो दिस इज द रेशियो एंड वी वांट टू y, तो y इज 100. तो फ्रेंड्स, इफ वी हैव गिवन द रेशियो देन वी कैन फाइंड द अदर लेंथ ब्रेथ और अदर थिंग्स. Friends, today we study about sum number 12, 13 and 14, 15 and 16 sum. I will send you from YouTube and next year we will start the chapter number 13. Okay, thanks a lot. Jai Swaminarayan.